Greedy Activision has struck again because they announced that, hey, if you want to get the next-gen version of Black Ops Cold War, you got to pay them an extra $10. Basically saying, hey, we're making games $70 now, not $60, which is absolutely ridiculous. I mean, I know $10 isn't that much in the grand scheme of it, and I'm sure a lot of people are just going to pay it, no problem. It's just really annoying because you look at companies like Microsoft and with Xbox, they're saying, hey, you bought this game once, or hey, you have Game Pass, you don't need to pay for an upgrade for this game. You get it. So any game I own on my current Xbox One, I get the next-gen version of the Series X free of charge. I don't have to pay anything extra just to get, let's say, the updated version of the Master Chief Collection. So why is Activision kind of trying to normalize this? And I think there was some sort of announcement with the NBA 2K21, where they were like, hey, let's make that $70. And it's just like, seriously, these multi-billion dollar corporations need more money? Again, people are going to pay for it, so obviously they ran the numbers. They have somebody in their internals that was like, no, this will be beneficial for us in the long run. Like, yeah, some people are going to be pissed, but like in the grand scheme of it, it's going to make them a lot more money, for sure. Millions of dollars extra is going to be made on this extra $10. It's just like, imagine simping for a multi-billion dollar corporation for $10. Being like, oh, well, it should be more because, you know, you're getting a new game. You're getting the better version. It's like, okay, when I buy a new phone, do I need to purchase every single app or game I had on my old phone on the new one? Like when I upgraded from an iPhone 6S to an iPhone XR, I didn't need to buy all my apps and games again. Why do I got to do that for an Xbox game? Why is that what's going on? It is just so fucking stupid. I went to school for marketing, so like I understand it. It's like, hey, there's demand for this product. People are going to be willing to pay for it, especially if it's a good product. So this extra $10, people are going to shill it out. It's unavoidable. It's going to happen, and more companies are going to follow suit, and it's just really kind of anti-consumer. And I like the way that Microsoft and Xbox is kind of handling next-gen, where they're super consumer-friendly. They're probably losing out on millions of dollars by being like, hey, no, you know, you don't have to buy all these games. You can get Game Pass. You can do this and that. I'm sure there's millions of dollars being lost there, but they're kind of just trying to build up the reputation and be like, hey, we're really consumer-friendly over here, whereas Activision is just like, hey, fuck you, give us money. We really need that $10 or we're going to go under. It's like, dude, all right, if you're going to require 10 extra dollars for this game, you better pay your fucking employees some more. From my understanding, some people don't get paid a fuck ton. Like, seriously, pay all your development teams and every single employee a pretty damn good wage. Don't fuck them over on crunch time and this and that with all these like, it really annoys me. Maybe I'm a fucking communist because I want the next-gen version game for free, but fuck it, that's just what I'm going to be then, because the fact that I got to pay an extra $10 to get... I mean, you could still play, like, the Xbox One version on the Series X. It's just going to be a little worse. Like, it's not going to look as good, and it will run better, objectively, on the newer gen of consoles, whether you're playing PS5, Xbox, or whatever. But if you want to get the full next-gen capability, it's like, pay $10 to unlock better frame rate. Like, what... I've never had that I don't know. And, like, with COD Ghost, because COD Ghost came out right at a console launch time, I remember, I got the Xbox One version for free. We bought the physical version of Ghost at GameStop, and when the Xbox One came out, we bought an Xbox One, and it was like, hey, you bring your 360 version of COD Ghost to GameStop within, like, 30 days of the new console, give the Xbox One version for free. Why? Why are we changing? Why are we I got no real words for this. It's just super annoying. It's not a deal breaker, like you gotta pay an extra like $60 for the game again, but it's still just like, they're just trying to test the waters. Like, how far can we go with this? So, I don't know. There better be no fucking microtransactions if you're making me pay 10 extra dollars just to get a better version of it. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Are you excited for Black Ops Cold War? The reveal is definitely interesting. It's a game I'm kind of excited to play. I'm just kind of annoyed with greedy companies, but... that's capitalism for you. It's gonna happen. So we'll see what happens in the coming months with Black Ops Cold War. Thank you guys for listening. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Cheerio, mates.